Hello viewers, today we are going to start the rest of the part of chapter number 2, the Northern Fertile Plains. Our today's topic, the Ganga Basin and the Brahmaputra Basin. Look at the map. At first, we are going to discuss about the Ganga Basin. To the east of the Sutlej Basin lies the Ganga Basin. It is the largest part of Northern Fertile Plains. Delhi, Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal lie in this part. The Ganga and the Yamuna are the major rivers in this region. The source of the river Ganga lies in the glacier of the Himalayas called Gangotri. As the glacier melts, the Ganga appears in a small trickle of water. It becomes bigger inside as it is joined by the rivers Mandakini, Alakananda and by other small mountain streams. As the stream of water goes down through the mountains, it washes away rocks and collects plenty of sediments. By the time it reaches the plains at Haridwar. At Haridwar, it comes out of mountains to plains. As the river Ganga enters West Bengal, it gets divided into two streams. One of the streams is called the Hooghly, which flows into West Bengal. The other stream flows into Bangladesh, where it is known as the Padma. The Yamuna River joins the Ganga near Allahabad. The Yamuna, the Gamati, Gharghara, Gandak and the Koshi rivers join her from the north. But the Chambal, Betwa, Ken, Son, Damodar rivers join her from the south. Right? Look at the diagram. When the river nears the sea, the sediment becomes too heavy for it to carry and small islands are formed. The islands divide the river water into many streams called distributaries. A region with such islands and streams around them is called a delta. It is generally triangular in shape, right? The Yamuna is another important river of the basin. It also has its source in a Himalayan glacier called Yamunotri. The land between the Ganga and the Yamuna is called Doab. Many important and holy cities are located in this part of the plains. Among them are Delhi, Agra, Kanpur, Lucknow, Patna, Kolkata, Allahabad, Varanasi, etc. The main crops in Delhi, Uttarakhand and Uttar Pradesh are wheat and sugarcane. Jowar, bajra, barley, rice are also grown here. Rice and jute are the major crops of Bihar. The rainfall in the eastern part of Ganga is heavier than the rainfall in its western part. The main crops in West Bengal are rice, tea and jute. The climate is hot and humid in summer and cool in winter. Now come to the next topic, the Brahmaputra Basin. This basin is surrounded on three sides by hills and mountains. The Garo Hills, the Khasi Jayantia Hills and the Naga Hills are in the south of this basin. These are to the eastern part of the northern fertile plains. The Brahmaputra is the chief river of this basin. It rises in Manasarovar, a Himalayan lake. It first flows through Tibet for a long distance, where the Brahmaputra is known as the Shangpo. It breaks through the eastern end of the Himalayas and turning west, the Brahmaputra enters the plain through a long valley in Assam. Okay. Then it turns south and enters Bangladesh, where it joins one of the branches of the Ganga. These two rivers form a big delta called the Sundarbans Delta. The lower part of this region is marshy and is covered with forest. This forest is called the Sundarbans because of the Sundari trees growing here. Mountain streams from all sides join the Brahmaputra. The rainfall in this region is very high. It overflows its banks, causing floods. Tea is grown on the slopes of the hills. Guwahati, Dibrugarh, and Digboi are some important towns of this region. Right? So, students, here I close the chapter for today. Thank you. Have a good day.